Samsung make impressive phones, but most of them are flagships and they're ultra expensive. And not all of us have that kind of budget. So now I will want to present you 3 phones that you can get for $100. The phones I'm recommending today are the Samsung Galaxy A10e, Galaxy Note 5, and Galaxy S8. So I will go with the A10e first. Yeah, A10e and not A10. And it costs about $120, brand new on eBay. So this phone is a 2019 phone, and what you're getting for that is really quite impressive, as you're packing a 5.83-inch LCD panel with a resolution of 720 by 1560, which is not a bad resolution at all, especially given this price. On the plastic back, you're getting an 8-megapixel rear camera that can shoot videos in 1080p at 30fps. At the front, you're getting a 5-megapixel camera that can shoot in 720p, and that is okay for the price, not the best, but acceptable. On the upside of this phone is that you get Android 9 Pie. That is one of the latest software versions right now, and it's a great deal. This is the highlight of this phone, that it runs one of the latest software. However, please note that this phone doesn't have the most powerful chip, and it only has 2GB of RAM and 32GB of storage. Storage wise, it's okay, as there's a SD card slot with 512GB available if you can buy an SD card. It doesn't cost much, and I think that's a great deal actually. So I think this wraps up this phone. It's mainly for those that want the latest few software, as there's dark mode included in this. Dark mode is like a dark theme, I think most of you will know it. The 3000mAh battery might be a bit small, but for this phone that don't have to push so much, it is 100% usable. And like most phones at this price point, you're getting a dual SIM and a SD card slot. Now let's look at the next phone, which is the Samsung Galaxy Note 5, which can be found for about $110 for refurbished or used. And what you're really getting for that is a 5.7-inch display with a resolution of 1440 by 2560. As you can tell, the resolution is higher, and it's not only the resolution. Although a 2015 released phone, this phone is actually kind of more powerful than the previous phone, even if that is 2019, as this is a flagship phone from 2015 and it has better specifications overall. Like, instead of a standard LCD TFT panel, you have a Super AMOLED capacitive touchscreen. And this also have Corning Gorilla Glass, but however, it runs on Android 7.0 Nougat and it doesn't go any further. But you can install a custom ROM and get Android 10 even. If you want to see a video about that, tell me in the comments below and I will probably make one soon. Okay, let's get back into the video. As this is an older flagship, you're also getting a better camera actually, as it has optical image stabilization with 16 megapixels that can shoot in 4K at 30 frames per second. The front camera is also better, not by a lot. It is a 5-megapixel sensor, but it can shoot in 1440p at 30 frames per second. Storage wise, you can choose 32 to 128GB, there's 3 ranges, but all has 4GB of RAM, and that is actually much better, significantly better than the previous phone. But has the same battery capacity as the previous one. It is at 3000mAh battery, but it supports wireless charging, and it also supports fast charging. The other one also does, 15W, which is quite useful, especially when we run our battery. It also can support Samsung Pay, but isn't really something that I use. As this is Samsung's Note series phone, you will get a stylus, or what Samsung calls the S Pen, which can be pretty useful if you are gonna edit a photo, for example, you have to drag and drop, and the stylus just makes it easier. The final phone we'll be talking today is the Samsung Galaxy S8. Note that this is not the S8 Plus, as the Plus variant costs 50% more. For $100, This feels so good that I feel like I'm cheating. Firstly, the display I'm getting is a 5.8-inch AMOLED panel with a resolution of 1440 by 2960, an even higher resolution. Unlike the Note 5, there's no more physical buttons and you only get the in-display buttons, which is actually more modern. But the bezels are bigger, unlike the A10e, as this is an older phone from 2017. Which means you're getting a later software compared to the Note 5, as you can get Android 9 Pie, same as the A10e, on this phone. As this phone is a 2017 flagship, the performance of this phone is significantly better than the 2. But just like the other two phones, you have a 3000 mAh battery, which is a bit small, especially considering how much this phone has to push. The battery is also likely to degrade over the years. This phone has 64GB of internal storage with an SD card that can expand up to 512GB. The rear camera has 12 megapixels with a wide-angle lens and an optical image stabilization. The front-facing camera has 8 megapixels and it can shoot in 1440p, while the back can shoot in 4K 30 frames per second. Out of the three phones, I'll recommend this one the most, but the Note 5 has the stylus and the A10e is just a more modern phone with a more modern vibe. But this phone has the best features and also looks really modern, and the pricing is good. I mean, you might be thinking, why don't get the Note 8? But the Note 8 is about 2.5 times to 2 times more expensive than this phone, which is kind of absurd actually. Unless you can find a good deal, go for the S8, as this is a great deal. Okay, so just to sum it all up, I will lay down the specifications right now. If you have any questions, please remember to leave them down in the comments and I'll try to answer them. I have an ongoing giveaway, and the link is right up there. Click it and learn how to join the giveaway. It's international. Out of the three phones, which phone do you think is the best? Leave them down in the comments below. Remember to hit like and smash subscribe, and I'll join you in the next one.